Ramayanam. ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करम् शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ॐ समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम् ॐ अखण्डमण्डलाकारं व्याप्तं येन चराचरं तत्पदं दर्शितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुदेवो महेश्वरः गुरुरेव परं ब्रह्मा तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बन्धुश्च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव हरि ओम् प्रणाम्स् टु ईच् अण्ड् एव्री वन् Hearty welcome to our Atma Bodha Satsang. So we will chant the first verse of Atma Bodha, then we will go to our class. Tapo bhikshina papanam shantanam vitaraginam mumukshunam apekshoyam Atma Bodho vidhiyate. आत्मबोधो विधीयते. ए क्वालिफाइड स्टूडेंट हु इज एंडोर्ड विथ विवेक वैराग्य इत्यादि लक्षण ही गोज टू टीचर एंड ही विल लिसन this Upanishad teachings from the teacher, Sravana Manana Ityadi Karyakram. Then he will realize his own self as Satta Chit Ananda Parabrahma Eka Vastu. Initially, the same student used to think he himself as body, mind, intellect. Now his knowledge is, I am pure consciousness, pure existence, and pure bliss, janana marana raga dvesha ityadi rahita akhanda advaita brahma. He will be called as Jivan Mukta Purusha. Jivan Mukta Purusha means he is liberated while living only. Because he was bound while living on. So the answer also should be in the same body. Here only he thought, I am bound. Now his knowledge is, I am free. Jivan Mukta Purusa. Where the bondage is, there should be the freedom, not somewhere else. If we say it is somewhere else, it is a promise. It is not a fact. So, he is the Jivan Mukta Purusha. After dropping body also, the same Purusha will be called as Videha Mukta. You know, nothing can bind him. He is without body also liberated. Here his name is called Jivan Mukta. After that his name is called Videha Mukta. Today class topic is about that great Mahatma. Bhagavan Shankaracharya, both topics. About Jivan Mukta Stiti, about Videha Mukta Stiti, he is going to discuss. In today's class, we will talk about Jivan Mukta Stiti. In the next class, we will talk about Videha Mukta Stiti. Very nice, Swamiji. To know about great Mahatmas and their condition, their status, we can say, their glory. It itself great inspiration for the seekers like us, who are the beginners and very, very fresh to this great path. One student, now he is a Swami in US. When he joined in Sandipni Sadhanalaya, he was very, very, very young boy. Like teenager, 18, 19 years young boy. In Sandipni, they teach all Shankara Bhashya and Upanishad, this and that. You know? Because of his age, he could not catch that knowledge. One day, but he is Chinmaya Yogakendra member. He is a devotee of Gurudev. And he ran to Gurudev and he said, Gurudev, Gurudev, I could not understand this, you know, deep subjects and all the theories and everything. Then Gurudev said, if you want to grow in spiritual field, read the charitras of great Mahatmas. Like Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Ramana Maharshi, Swami Vivekananda, and read their life histories. That will be definitely an inspiration that can boost your spiritual progress. That way, we have to know about this great Mahatma's status. Here, Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji, in today's class, he is going to enumerate. The title of this Mahatma he has given is, his name is Atma Rama. He is not Ayodhya Rama, he is not Kausalya Rama, he is not Sita Rama. His name is Atma Rama Mahapurusha. Atma Rama means this Rama, this Mahatma, he is in our Atma Stiti. The name of this Jivan Mukta is Atma Rama. Beautifully from the verse 50, he is saying, this verse 50 is nothing but Ramayanam. Swamiji, suddenly how Rama can come into this Vedanta? Shankar Bhagavat Pada, he brought Bhagavan Ram. Verse number 50. Repeat after me. Tirdhva moharnavam hatva. Raga dveshadi rakshasan yogi shanti samayuktaha atma ramo virajate. Together. Tirdhva moharnavam hatva ragadveshadi rakshasan yogi shanti samayuktaha atma ramo virajate. This Atma Rama Mahatma virajate is a shining. If you have any chance to listen, Pujya Gurudev Atma Bodha Satsanga Sar talks, he took 45 minutes to explain this sloka number 50, Pujya Gurudev. From the beginning of the Ramayana, Dasaratha, Kaushalya, Sita, and Bharata, Lakshmana, Shatrughna, Ayodhya, and the mandara. That is called spiritual significance of Ramayana. Actually, if you want to discuss that topic, we have to take complete one session. What is Dasaratha? What is Kausalya? And how they can get Rama? And why Kaikeyi behaved like that? And what is this Aranya Vasam? Who is this Maricha? Who is this Ravana? Beautifully he spoke 45 minutes. So here Bhagavan Shankaracharya is writing Ramayana only. Tirdhva, this Atma Rama Sadaka, Tirdhva Moha Arnavam. Arnavam means ocean. Which ocean, Swamiji? Moha Arnavam. The ocean name is Moham. Moham means delusion. The first step he did is Tirdhva. Tirdhva means first he crossed this delusion, ocean of delusion. Tirdhva Moharnavam. In Ramayana, Bhagavan Ramji, he crossed that ocean. We say Ram Setu. From Tamil Nadu to Sri Lanka. Okay. Tirdhva Moharanam. Then what he did, Swamiji, this sadhaka, Hatva Ragadveshadi Rakshasan. Hatva means having killed. Whom he killed, Swamiji? Rakshasan. Rakshasan means demons. What are the names of demons, Swamiji? Raga, Dvesha, Adi. Likes and dislikes and so on. All the Rakshasan he killed. Then Swamiji, then in Ramayana, he got his Sita. Bhagavan Ram. For Adhyatmik Sadhaka, Sitaji is nothing but Shanti. Shanti Samayuktaha Yogi. So if you want Shanti, we have to cross over the delusion and we have to kill likes and dislikes. Then only we are going to get Shanti. Otherwise, Ashanti. This yogi, Shanti Samayuktaha, he got that peace. Samayuktaha means he is endowed with Shantiji. Shanti means Sita. Samayuktaha. Then Atma Ramaha Virajate. This Rama, this Atma Rama Virajate. Virajate means he is shining. Now he is Atma Rama. No more Prapancha Arama. Arama means delighted. He is delighted with his own self. This Atma Rama Yogi. Virajate. Virajate means he is shining. This is the Ramayana story only. Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji, he brought in Atma Bodha. There is another Vedantic text called Rama Gita. That is from Adhyatma Ramayana, written by Veda Vyas ji. If you see that Rama Gita, some talks are there. Chinmaya Mishra Acharyas, they talk on that Rama Gita. Not Rama Gita from Tulsi Ramayana, Rama Gita from Adhyatma Rama. Gurudev talks also there. Guruji also spoke on that. That Rama Gita and this Atma Bodha, almost same. Same examples, same thought pattern, same presentation. Shankaracharya ji must be inspired from that book. This Adhyatma Ramayana is nothing but a spiritual Rama. Valmiki Ramayana, we know. Valmiki Ramayana is Dharma Rama. Ramo Vikrahavan Dharmaha, Valmiki Ramayana. Tulsi Ramayana, Bhakta Rama. Whereas this Adhyatmik Ramayana is spiritual Rama. In that Rama Gita is there, teaching between Vasishta and Rama, or Lakshmana or Rama, same like Atma Bodha, same, ditto. So here he brought here. We know Ramayana. So Guruji always used to say in talks, if you don't know Ramayana, at least read Bal Ramayana. Swamiji, we don't know Sanskritam. We cannot read Valmiki Ramayanam. We don't know Hindi. So we cannot read Tulsi Ramayana. At least you read Bal Ramayana. If you know Ramayana story, then well and good. So in Ramayana, Bhagavan Ram, as a sadhaka or as a jiva, his shanti will be stolen away. Sitaji kidnapped. And they kept in an island such a way, no one can go there. Because around that island, big ocean is there. So we cannot go there. Very, very difficult to get our own shanti. See, this Atma Shanti is our own self, still very, very difficult to get. Why Swamiji very difficult to get? Because there are two powers. One is called veiling power, another is called projecting power. Veiling power is nothing but ignorance. To penetrate through the ignorance, definitely we need teacher, study and everything. That veiling is nothing but moha arnavam. It is a shoreless ocean. When it started, we don't know. How depth it is, we don't know. Actually, we want to dry this ignorance. But we don't know how depth it is, how big it is. This moha arnavam. Therefore, first we must kill our ignorance. That is called tirdhva moha arnavam. Swamiji, what should we do to kill this moha arnavam, Swamiji? Sravanam. Because knowledge only can eliminate ignorance. These two are. So acquire knowledge from the teacher continuously. Slowly you will cross over this ignorance belt. Bhuri Sravanam, Upanishad says, listen again and again, listen again and again, listen again and again from the teacher with Shraddha and Bhakti. Slowly, clearly, we will understand ourselves. That is called Tirdhva Moha Arnava. And after that, one more problem is there. That is called Ragadveshadi Rakshasham. That is another problem of our mind. That is projecting mind means there is a happiness in the world. World only giving happiness, so I am liking. World only giving sorrow, therefore I am disliking. This likes and dislike like Ravana and Kumbhakarna. Adi means Ityadi also there. Meghanada Ityadi. We must kill them. You know, Swamiji, what should we do to kill this Ragadvesha? That is called sadhana. This Sravana Ityadi Jnana Samuparja. And we have to keep that knowledge with us. So to keep that knowledge, we need a pure mind. Pure mind we can get by different spiritual practices. If we slowly do the spiritual practices, then we don't label anything as a good thing, anything as a bad thing. Because we will came to know everything is Brahman only. One only truth. So this Ragadveshadi Rakshasan, to kill them, we need sadhana. Sadhana only can kill projection of mind. Knowledge only can kill veiling of the knowledge. So if you do this work, purification of the mind and clarification of the knowledge, then this yogi, this meditator, this sadhaka, this mahatma, shanti samayuktaha, then he will come to experience shantam from his own bosom. From his own antakarana only, the fountain of peace will come out. That is the result of spiritual practice of above two. yogi shanti samartha. And he will come to know his own address, his own house, that is called Atmarama. And he will stay there like how Swamiji virajate, like a chakravarti in a throne. Like a king in a throne, he sits with Sitaji, with Shanti Sitaji, and that Mahatma is Atmarama. So this way, about that Jivan Mukta Purusha, Mahatma, Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji written this sloka. This is the status of Jivan Mukta. Swamiji, very nice Swamiji. And Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji saying about the same Atmarama Yogi only, or Jivan Mukta Purusha in 51 verse, how he is Bahya Nitya Shukha Saktim. Hitvatma Sukha Nivrutaha. Ghatastha Deepavat Swasthaha. Svantareva Prakashate. Again, together. Bahya Nitya Sukha Shaktim. Hitvatma Sukha Nivrutaha. Gatastha Deepavat Swasthaha. Svantareva Prakashate. This Mahatma, Bahya Anitya Sukha Asaktim Hitva. Again, like previous verse only, he will do two jobs. One is dropping. Second one is acquiring. What he is dropping, Swamiji? Asakti. Asakti means interest. On what, Swamiji, interest he is dropping? Sukha asakti. Sukha asakti means there is a happiness. Where, Swamiji? Bahya anitya vastushu. He is dropping his interest in an idea that worldly objects will give happiness to me. That false idea he completely dropped. Bahya anitya sukha asaktim hitva. His understanding is very clear. There is no happiness in the outside. So where is the happiness? Atma sukha nivruttaha. He confirmed sukham is nothing but my atma only. Atma sukha nivruttaha. He confirmed sukham only my atma only. And how is his situation, Swamiji? Ghatastha Deepavat Swastaha. He sits like a lamp in a pot. Ghatastha Deepavat. Why lamp in a pot, Swamiji? The lamp in the pot, it is stable, bright, unshaken, very, very clear. In the same way, this Mahatma, he sits in himself like Nishchala Deepavata. Where is this Atmarama, Swami? This Atmarama is in this Gata only. That's why we call him as Jivan Mukta. Gatastha Deepavat Swastaha. Then Antareva Prakashate. He signs in himself only. Very clearly. He shines himself. That is not the mind, that is not the thought, that is not the ignorance, that is not the ahankar. That is ప్రకాశ సత్త చిత్త ఆనంద బ్రహ్మస్వరూపం అహమేవా. అండ్ ఘటస్థ దీపవత్, హీ షైన్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ వెరీ బాడీ ఓన్లీ. దిస్ ఈస్ ద స్టేటస్ ఆఫ్ దట్ జీవన్ ముక్త పురుష మహాత్మ. ప్రకాశతే, దట్ గురుజీ ఆల్వేస్ సేస్ he is in himself. And you know, some people, they may say, Swamiji, this atma jyoti, this atma jnanam are the status of complete sanyama sthiti. He may lose any time. No, continuously, satatam he is aware of his blissful state. That's why if you see the mahatmas, they are always bliss. Because you just go inside, your palace is there. If you sit in that palace, this mind and body are problems, they cannot do anything. Because they are like shadows from that palace sight. Any moment he can go. Aram. Free. Muktaha. If he want to see, he can see the world. Otherwise, he shines himself, this Atma Rama Purusha. His glory is that. Very nice. But regarding the sloka number 51, this Mahatma, he says, there is no happiness in the worldly objects at all. That is completely myth, false knowledge that the world gives happiness. And he confirmed that happiness is nothing but my own self. I am happiness. My happiness is not because of anything. I am happiness. This is his knowledge. Okay, he studied, he understood, his glory is that. But as a students, we must get some knowledge in this topic. Guruji gives 2-3 ideas. Because our belief is world gives happiness. If you have more money, I will be happy. If you have more objects, I will be happy. If you have nice status in society, I will be happy. Very nice. So our understanding must be clear. That's why he gives some points. I will discuss with you all. He says the first point is, whatever we say, I am getting this from this, I am getting this from this, we say na. He says that is not called happiness. That is called as pleasure. In Sanskritam, we call pleasure as bhogam. Happiness we call as sukham. Hena? So Guruji says that is not happiness, that is a pleasure. How can you say, Swamiji, that is not happiness? Mahatma says, if you want to say anything as happiness, it should have two qualifications. One is, happiness should end sorrow. So there should be an end to the sorrow, then only we can call it as happiness. This is one. Second one is, happiness should bring peace, shanti. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, asantasya kutas sukham. You cannot claim, I am very peaceful if you don't have happiness. So, whatever, if you want to label as it is happiness, there should be an end to the sorrow and it should give peace to our mind. Otherwise, our antakarana should get a very peaceful mood. Whereas, these worldly objects, you know, how much you can enjoy. There is no end to the sorrow. And moreover, the pleasure, or what we call in Gurudev's language, it is like, you know, the tickling of sense objects. They give more agitation to the mind, not shanti. we compare with people. They give jealous, they give hatredness, they give quarrel, they give unrighteousness. How can you call it as a happiness? It is a shanti. So they give more and more agitation. So there may be a thrill in the worldly objects. There may be sense pleasure in the worldly objects, but it cannot be called as happiness. Whereas in Atma Jnana Vishayam, this is the complete end to the our sorrow. Second, unworldly peacefulness we will get, not any prapanchika shantam. That's why in Mundaka Upanishad, in Mandukya Upanishad, they say prapancha upasamanaha. In that mind, world disappear. Upasamanaha means there is no world for him. That kind of shanti we are going to get with Atma Sukham. Therefore, this worldly happiness you cannot call as happiness. This is one. Momentary moment we may get some thrill. And Guruji says, during that enjoyment also, there is a fear. I may lose this object. I may lose this man or women. I may lose this amount. And whatever worldly pleasures, during that enjoyment also, there is a fear of losing. That much uncertainty there in this worldly pleasures. This is one. Second problem is, whatever worldly happiness we say, we always, it is a claim. In future, I am going to get. This is like a complete contradiction. Actually, we want happiness right now. Then why don't you get right now? You sit in the chair and you should be happy. Right now means that is the meaning. But we say, no, Swamiji, I have to get a nice bank balance. Then only I will be happy. This is our understanding. This is the greatness of Maya Devi. Always, even now, we cannot say I am happy, Swamiji. Then when are you going to get happy? I do that, then I will get it. That will give happiness. This is called Bhava Roga in Vedanta. Bhava means always in future. When I was a very, very young boy, I say when I grow, then I will be happy. Now my mother and father every day beating me. If I grow up, they don't beat me, I will be happy. When I grow, I should get a job. When I get a job, I should get married. When I get married, I should get children. When I get children, children should get to settle well. When they settled well, my health should be perfect. When you already become old. So, always we superimpose happiness in future. I know. See how contradiction it is. And you are claiming, I am happy with world, I am happy with world, I am happy with world. So this is another drawback. And third one is, Guruji says, quantitatively, we are changing the world always. When our grandfather was there, world is in different shape. When our father was there, whatever, world shape is different. Now I am here. Now world shape is definitely, we are changing quantitatively world shape. But you know, qualitatively, if you ask anyone, how are you? Same as it is. Next generation cannot claim we are happy. Same, some other problems will be there. Because this is all because of wrong notion, false understanding that we are superimposing happiness in the outside. We are not seeking happiness inside. If you correct it, this is called Atma Sukha Nivrittaha. He turned towards himself. And as a spiritual practice for all of us, Pooja Guruji says, you should be peace with each and everything. He did not say you should be happy with each and everything. You should be peaceful with each and everything. If you get that mind status, you are spiritually progressing. Don't lose your shanta sthiti. Oh, this is the spiritual sadhana, Swamiji. We should be peaceful always. You know, we can be peaceful all the time if we know our own identity. Mind cannot trouble, because this is all mind's magics only. The same wrong knowledge will be washed away when you thought of yourself as Satchit-Ananda-Parabrahma. That Mahatma ito, always he will be aware of his blissful self. And no fear of losing also, because that is his own nature. Like how coolness is the nature of the water. Sometime water may be boiled, but it cannot be permanently boiled, because it is not its nature. Its nature is always cool. Again, it will go to his own status only. In the same way, this Mahatma, this yogi, always he is aware of his own nature, and there is no fear of losing also. Whereas this world, always fear of losing, including our physical body, our relations, our friends, our family, our object, everything, uncertainty only in the world. There is no certainty. So that clarity he got, and then this Mahatma, Ghatastha Deepavat Swastaha, he is shining like a lamp in the ghata. There is no holes for this ghata. Holes means there is no attachments. There is no asakti. Why, you know? Because from there, everyone is Brahman. Why should I degrade them? Why should I insult them? He is big, he is small. There is no need to see that way. From if I am Atma, means everyone is Atma. With that vision, he will drop all differences, that Advaita Darsana Shukha Atmavan, this Mahatma. Swamiji, and please tell some more about this Jivan Mukta Purusha Lakshanam. That will be in verse number 52. Upadhistopi tad dharmaihi. Alipto vyoma van munihi. Sarvavin mudhavattishtet asakto vayuvacharet. Together. Upadisthopi taddharmaihi alipto vyoma van munihi. Sarvavin mudhavattishtet asakto vayuvacharet. One more greatness of this Mahatma, particularly in verse number 52, Bhagavan Shankaracharya wants to say, this Jivan Mukta Purusha is Sarvajna. Sarvajna means all knower. Generally, we say these Mahatmas are great, great Mahatmas. They know everything. Many people, they say, you just go and sit in front of Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. Whatever you want to ask, that answer will be there. He doesn't speak anything, but question will be solved. Like in Gurudev life also, many people, they say, if you go in front of Gurudev, both spiritually and materially also, if you have any question, that will be answered in his presence only. Or some people, they say in worldly problems also, they may go to, I will see Mahatma, my agitation of mind will go. It will go. That Shakti in the mind only they can do. That is called Sarvavit. About that quality, in verse number 52, Shankaracharya is saying, Upadhisthopi, this Mahatma, Upadhisthaha. Staha means he sits. Where, Swamiji? In Upadhi. Mean he is with body, mind and intellect, everything. Because he is a Jevan Mukta. He is living like us. Generally, our ignorance is our ignorance only, always. Gurudev himself told this story. When Gurudev finished his study with his guru, Tapovanji Maharaj told him, now everything completed. You please go to your own home and stay some days with your family. Guru gave permission. Aha. And one more thing I am telling, go by foot. Don't go by train or bus and anything. By walk, you go to Kerala from Himalayas too. You know, we may think, you know, he's troubling him. No, 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 no. Now you are Jivan Mukta Purusha, great Mahatma you are. If you walk all the country, everything will be blessed. From Kashmir to Kerala. He did not tell, but that is his, he wants to say. Go by walk. He took so many days with different halts. Pooja Gurudev, he walked from Uttarkashi to Kerala. That village people, because of this Balakrishna Menon, as a young boy, he left that village. Now he is a sannyasi from Himalayas. Whole village came to know, this will be there in every village. Amara Balakrishna Menon came, his friends, his relatives, all village people, they want to come to see him. Many people, they came, he is shining like a sun. They did namaskar, namaskar, Swami Chinmayananda, Swami Chinmayananda, Swami Chinmayananda. One man came. He asked his family what he is doing, Swamiji. They said, you know, Swamiji now taking bath. So he waited. After half an hour, he asked what Swamiji is doing. They said, Swamiji is taking breakfast. Okay. He waited, and after half an hour, this what Swamiji is doing now? Swamiji reading newspaper. This man said, "Are, if a Swamiji also does bathing and eating and reading newspaper like us, what is his special glory?" He thought this man also like us only, and he left and gone. In the same way, many people, when we see the Mahatmas, "Are, Swamiji, they are all behaving like us." I thought Mahatma means they will have some special contributions and special glory, aura, and this nothing. Upadhistaha. Upadhistaha means he is also like a common man. If you go to see Swami Tejomayananji, Swami Tejomayananji also comes and likes and sits in the chair. He cracks jokes and he also eats whatever if you eat. You have seen, he sings and everything like common man. Then what is his greatness, Swamiji? Upadhistopi tad dharmaihi aliptaha. But inside, he is aliptaha. Aliptame means never contaminated by their dharmas. Physical body dharmas, mind dharma, intellect dharmas, or any surrounding dharmas. He is never contaminated by them because he is Atma Rama. This is the difference that we cannot see. No one can see, in fact. So, upadhistopi tad dharmaihi aliptaha. So, how he will be, Swami? Vyomavat munihi. This muni, like vyoma. Vyoma means like space. Space also never contaminated by anything. Let the great storm may come. let the big rain may come, thunders may come, or nothing may be there. All the time space give accommodation to all. At the same time, it never touches anything. This is the actual great spiritual practice. You cannot avoid the world. Swamiji, I am practicing Vedanta, so I want to drop my body. You cannot. It will drop sometime. Whenever time comes, it will drop. So we have to be in this world. At the same time, we should not be contaminated. We should be pure. Prakashavat, like sun, like space. Vyomavat, this muni. This is one quality. Another quality is, he is sarvavit. Sarvavit means this Mahatma is sarvajna purusha. Sarvajna purusha means, if we know what to be known, then there is no need to know anything else. That is nothing but truth. That common factor of everything, that is called sarva vijnatvam. The common factor of each and everything he knew, this is nothing but pure existence, pure consciousness, and pure bliss. And particularly, there may be some visheshanas will be there. Some are intellect projections, some are mind projections, some are body projections, there will be there. So that common truth, that one, that main cause of everything, he know that. That's why he is called Sarvajna. For example, he wants to know in particular. For example, he wants to know in particular, whatever, he will come to know that also there for Mahatmas. But they may not be interested in knowing those things, but he has that capacity also, because that is because of Sattva Buddhi. In the spiritual practices time only, this buddhi will be purified. Even our buddhi also, if it is concentrated, if it is pure, we also can penetrate in some truths. That is called revealing the truths. Who is revealing? The buddhi only revealing. Swamiji, we discovered that, we identified that, you know. This is all because of purity of buddhi only. This Mahatma is Suddha Sattva. Purest of the pure, his intellect. So easily, effortlessly, he can know anything, he can do anything, he can command anything. He can command anything. If he says, Devendra, do that, Devendra will come and do. I know. Parameshwara, you come and do it, Parameshwara will come and do. Vasudeva, you do it, Vasudeva will do. That is his buddhi great. Vishuddha Sattva. That's why Mahatma says, this Jivan Mukta Purusha, this Mahajnani, he is much more bigger than Trimurtis also. Even Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara also, you know, they are less than this Mahatma. Once Pooja Guru, somebody asked Pooja Gurudev, 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 whether God is great or this realized master is great. And Gurudev says, how can you drag that Mahatma to this level? Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara level. How can you drag him? He is great forever. They have duty, srishti, sthiti, laya, and upadi, this and that. That Brahma is, whatever he says, it will happen. I want a new Brahmanda will come. Nobody can control. And in Viveka Chodamani, Gurudev says, this entire disturbance of world, he uses that word. This entire disturbance of the world is like, you know, if you put any dhoti on your shirt, if sometimes for a wind, that dhoti may move, that man may know, may not know. Or he may come to know that my dhoti is moving because of the wind, or he may not know my dhoti is not moving. This entire world of disturbance is like for him. He is in his own status. So, Sarvavit Mahatma, this great Mahatma, Upanishad, how much glorified? They say, even Sakami Purusha, anyone like us, if we go there and if we want anything, if we pray, he may not know that we are praying, but it will be fulfilled. Sarvakaman Purayati, Upanishad says. Great, much, much bigger than Bhagavan. We can say that also. So Sarvavitto, this Mahatma, but you know, Bhagavan Shankaracharya is using Modhavattishtati. But he also behaves like Modha people like us only. Very simple. Eating, bathing, dressing, going, whatever work he has. And some people, they hide also. In their whole lifetime, completely society we ignore. We ignore them. They may be great because they don't want anything. Everything is okay for them. If we don't respect also, okay. If we respect also, okay. So, Bindas. Guruji says one story in Punjab. There is a Pandit in Punjab. So, this Pandit, he is teaching meditation. Many people came to that meditation class. Panditji is teaching meditation. One old man, he sat on the chair. And you know, because he did not see that condition of the chair, this old man is going to fall down from the chair. This Pandit in meditation only, he has seen that. And he in meditation only, he instructed with his name. Before that, he doesn't know his name. For example, his name is Venkateshwar Rao. Venkateshwar Rao, you are falling down, please take care. This Venkateshwar Rao, he got and he said, hey, my child. And this Venkateshwar Rao, he said, Mahatma, Mahatma, Mahatma. In meditation also, you can see the entire world, this and that, he did namaskar. But the next session of the meditation, everyone is there, but this Pandit is escaped. He doesn't want to reveal. Some Mahatmas may be like that. And they are Vasantavat Chare. Some Mahatmas, they do so much work. They do so much social work. Everywhere they go and teach and stay and this and that, they guide. Somebody asked Shankaracharya, why this Mahatma is doing like this? Shankaracharya said, you cannot stop the spring. He is like Vasantavat. If he comes only, entire world will be fulfilled. Entire world will get saubhagyam. Everything will be get fructified with his presence, not by anything else. Vasantavat charet, this Mahatma. So that way, this Mahatma has his own glory, this Jivan Mukta Purushas. Many people, they may get good people, good friends. Many people, they may get God company also. God company also, many people, they get upasaka sityadi. But you know, Mahapurusha samsrayam, very, 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 very few. Atyanta durlabham. It is not a common thing to get the great Mahapurusha samsrayam. Lucky our Gurudev and Guruji ityadi, great, great Mahatmas, they are blessing. If they want to hide, they can hide. But they are blessing the world with their teachings, with their love, and with their krupa. This is all because this is not a job for them. This is all their krupa. Jivan Mukta Purusha, great Mahatma Stiti is this. Next class, Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji. He explains Videha Mukti. If this great Mahatma, if he drops the body, then what will be? That is another topic. These are all called Vedantic topics. అయినా. సో వన్ అనౌన్స్మెంట్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు ప్రజెంట్ దట్ ఈస్ చిన్మయ మిషన్ విశాఖపట్నం టుమారో ఈజ్ మాస శివరాత్రి డే. ఎవ్రీ మంత్ వీ విల్ గెట్ వన్ శివరాత్రి, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ మాస శివరాత్రి. సో వీఆర్ డూయింగ్ అతిరుద్రం, బిగ్ రుద్రాభిషేక ఫర్ భగవాన్ శివ. ఇన్ దిస్ అతిరుద్రం 121 టైమ్స్ దే డూ రుద్రాభిషేక విత్ కంప్లీట్ రుద్రా చాంటింగ్. మతలబ్ 121 టైమ్స్ దే చాంట్ రుద్రం విత్ 121 ద్రవ్యాస్ దే డూ అభిషేక ఫర్ భగవాన్ శివ. దిస్ ఇస్ కంప్లీట్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఫ్రమ్ మార్నింగ్ 8:00 టు ఈవినింగ్ 8:00. ఫర్ దిస్ అతిరుద్రం దే నీడ్ 11 ముఖ్య యజమాన్స్. ముఖ్య యజమాన్స్ మీన్స్ 11 ఫ్యామిలీస్ దే షుడ్ సిట్. సో టు ప్రొవైడ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్, చిన్న మిషన్ హ్యాస్ టు ప్రొవైడ్ ఆల్ అర్చక స్వామి, భగవాన్ అండ్ ద్రవ్య, ప్రసాద అండ్ వస్త్ర, గురు, దక్షిణ ఇత్యాది టు ఎవ్రీ వన్. దే కెప్ట్ 50,000 ఇండియన్ రూపీస్ యాజ్ ముఖ్య యజమాన్. సో 11 యజమాన్స్ విల్ బి దేర్, దే షుడ్ స్పాన్సర్ 50,000 రూపీస్. స్వామీజీ ఆన్లైన్ ఆల్సో కెన్ వీ డూ? అఫ్ కోర్స్ ఆన్లైన్ ఆల్సో వీ కెన్ పార్టిసిపేట్ యాజ్ అ ముఖ్య యజమాన్ ఫర్ దిస్ అతిరుద్ర యజ్ఞం. Definitely that will be support to Chinmay Mission. At the same time, with your sankalpa, they do this Mukhya Yajna. In the same yajna, we have to put another platform. That is that if anybody wants to do 11 times Rudra Abhishek, that is called Yajna. So they put 5,000 Indian rupees to that Yajman sponsor. So 11 times not Abhishekam, 11 times Rudram chanting. So they do 11 times chanting. During the entire time, they have to do this Rudra Abhishekam. And for them also, there is a process of Satkara Ityadi. That is called Yajman. Other way, Swamiji, we want to, you know, entire day we want to do prasadam seva, we want to alankarana seva for Bhagavan, or we want to give dakshina seva for archaka. 15 archaka swamis will come, archaka brahmanas, 15 people they come, we want to give dakshina seva. Anything if you want to contribute, please contribute. I will share the posters with our Vijay, Buddepalli Vijayji, or our President Vijayji. I expect many people will contribute in this Atirudra Maha Abhishekam for Bhagavan Shiva. Few people already registered from our Kovaid Chinmay family. I am very grateful to them. Thank you very much. And please do that. Hari. ఓం పూర్ణమదః పూర్ణమిదం పూర్ణాత్ పూర్ణముదచ్యతే పూర్ణస్య పూర్ణమాదాయ పూర్ణమేవావశిష్యతే. ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతి. హరిః ఓం.